200 kilometers west of Ghana's capital, Accra, in the oil-rich western region, hosts the new twin land bank concept evolved by the Ghana Free Zones Authority. Exciting landscapes, multi-purpose enclave, exclusively packaged for every business type and associated lifestyle. It's a twin parcel offering the ideal business and investment environment. The Ghana Free Zones Authority, through its relentless quest for client satisfaction, has churned out twin benefit enclaves earmarked for Shama and Sekendi, 25 kilometers apart. It offers all the Ghana Free Zones Authority's iconic tax and levy exemptions, plus an unrivaled convenience package. All regulatory agencies within one area to aid smooth and hassle-free processing. Immediate access to the harbor will cut down logistics expenses and facilitate useful networks and linkages. A composite parcel of business and pleasure. Let's drive through the proposed enclaves. The Shama Yabio Export Processing Zone covers over 3,000 acres of seafront land, a dedicated industrial park, aptly positioned and poised to serve the petroleum and petrochemical sector. It will harness, provide the needed infrastructure, and support in downstream refinery, distribution, transit and supply chain business services, land for tank farms, storage yards for logistics and haulage contractors, manufacturing of chemical inputs and accessories. The Shama Export Processing Zone will serve as a hub for licensing and monitoring growing businesses in all the downstream and support services segment. 25 kilometers still westwards is the Sekendi Export Processing Zone, over 2,000 acres of land located at the Impinton area. Proximity to the country's second seaport with a direct road link, ideal for heavy industrial activities, wood processing and furniture manufacturing. Mineral processing will be one of the key activities here. Opportunities are endless for independent power generators, natural and recycled water producers, and telephone and communication service providers. The export processing zones are twin investment and lifestyle villages, bearing everything required from onset through manufacturing, processing to export, banking and insurance, light and heavy industrial areas, warehouses, oil refinery, police post, shopping center offering all household and domestic needs, food court, hospital block, workers' dormitories block, residential blocks, recreational areas, daycare centers, workshop and training center. A railway line will link the village to the Takrady harbor. Other networking infrastructure include a helipad and a jetty, dry port, dry dock, plus many other business-friendly and exciting features. We are sure you appreciate the concept and sharing our excitement. Join the Ghana Free Zones Authority as prospective investors and partners in the creation of this twin parcel of pure business in pleasure environment.
Yofi talked about that earlier on. That is our main focus as far as this particular arrangement is concerned or meeting is concerned. The outline is going to be the Free Zones Program incentives, service provided by GFZA, areas of operation, priority sectors, British companies in Ghana Free Zones, export processing zones. Specifically, we're going to talk about Sekendi Export Processing Zone and the Shama Land Bank. Opportunities in the enclave, procedure for establishment, and a few others that we may deem appropriate. Now, the Ghana Free Zones concept is a specialized concept set up by an Act of Parliament in 1985, Act 504, the Free Zones Act. This is a government institution that regulates activities of free zones in Ghana. You all know about free zones. Free zones is just a customs territory. And by this, government want to encourage export, decided to use export processing zones to attract investment through the export processing zones to export goods and services outside Ghana. And the free zones operate a very specialized concept. And the principle is 70-30. 70-30 in the sense that you cannot sell more than 30% of whatever you produce in Ghana. Whatever is produced, 70% must be exported. So that's how we operate. It is a 70-30 principle, a specialized arrangement which is export-oriented. It is also designed to encourage processing of food, mostly because this arrangement want to encourage agric, mostly, and general manufacturing. It combines both enclave systems and what we call single factory arrangement. Ghana is the only free zones in the world that operate this concept. That's a two-tier arrangement. Either you operate the enclave system or what we call the single factory system. Single factory in the sense that wherever in Ghana is designated, you operate in Ghana, you can still operate the concept. Everywhere in Ghana is designated as a free zones area. So you cannot just decide to only operate in the free zones concept or the free zones enclave before you be classified as a free zones company. You can operate outside the enclave and you can still be classified or be seen as a free zones company. Now, the program, I'm talking about the free zones program, is private sector driven. It means that the government is only a regulator. The free zones authority is only a regulator. We don't do anything apart from regulating activities of free zones enterprises. But it must be private sector driven. It means that private sector are encouraged to be part of it. That's why we have come here, to be able to talk to you about the concept, to encourage you to come in, to be part of the concept, because this is the only concept that has helped a lot of countries develop. Go to the UAE and Jabal Ali is helping free zones. Go to Morocco and you see Tonjamed is helping the country. Go to Ethiopia and Djibouti and you see that free zones is helping the country. The only concept that is left for Ghana to see proper development is the free zones concept, and that is why we are here to encourage or to attract investment to the free zones. Now, the incentives available. The first one is 100% exemptions from the payment of what we call import and export levies, sometimes direct and indirect levies or duties. Anytime you are a member of the free zones concept and you decide to bring raw materials for export or for production, whatever comes in attracts zero rates tax. It means that you don't pay any duty when you bring these things in. I'm talking about things like machines for production, even trucks that can help you in your operations, vehicles that will be necessary to help in your operations. All this will not attract any tax. Now, also, you are also exempted from the payment of what we call income taxes. In Ghana, income tax is 25%. And when you are exempted from paying 25%, it means that you have a lot of money to reinvest in business. That is why we are here today to tell you the good news about Ghana and how free zones is working well. It's an opportunity for you to come to the concert, because this will be an opportunity for you to get 100% exemptions in the payment of income taxes. You are also exempted from the payment of withholding taxes on profit. Withholding tax on profit, you get zero rate. You are also exempted from all the problems that may affect other people who do business in other parts of the world. Most people go through a lot of issues, because when there is change of government, people are not sure of the existence of their business tomorrow. People are not sure that their business will still be operational. People are not sure that the government may decide not to take over their business. But with free zones, you are sure that you can get a peace of mind to do your business. Services provided by the Free Zones Authority. The Ghana Free Zones Authority is a one-stop shop arrangement, which means that everything that is done at the Free Zones everything that must be done by the Free Zones companies are done or are facilitated by the Free Zones Authority. The Free Zones Authority is a one-stop shop. We do everything for the Free Zones enterprises. So that when you want resident permits, when you want registration of your vehicles, when you want to even have an emergency visa, when you want to get a passport for your wards and family, all these things are facilitated by the Free Zones Authority. So the Free Zones Authority stands in the middle. We do everything for you. You just come and do business. And that's all that we are talking about. Areas of operations. The Ghana Free Zones Authority have four priority areas. The first one is manufacturing. The Free Zones concept specifically focuses so much on manufacturing because we believe that that is where most people can easily be, like, most can get jobs, both skilled and unskilled labor. So we believe, as an authority, our interest mostly must be geared towards manufacturing. And that's our first priority area. The second one is services. We also look at those who want to do services such as data entry, call center arrangement, even fixing of ICT, and stuff like that. The Ghana Free Zones Authority sees services as a second important area that we want to look at. We also look at enclave development. The Free Zones concepts operate mostly through special economic zones, enclaves, what we call export processing zones, special economic zones, free trade zones. All these zones can also fall under the concept of free zone because most people also want to partner Ghana Free Zones Authority to build free zones enclaves or develop what we call industrial parks. We're talking about LMI earlier on. They have developed an industrial park in Dawa. It's a private organization, but they decided to partner Free Zone somehow in some of the operations, not all of them. So as an investor, you may want to partner the Ghana Free Zones Authority to build Free Zones enclaves. You may also decide to partner the Free Zones Authority to build special economic zones, specially meant to attract investment in export-oriented businesses. And there's an opportunity there for you. You can also decide to do what we call commercial business. In this case, we are talking about adding value to raw materials or raw products. And when you decided to do that, you can also venture into free zones. So it is not only for people who want to do general manufacturing, but those who want to also do repackaging. You can decide to import and repackage for export. You can also fall under the free zones concept. So there's an arrangement for you there. There's also area for people who want to venture into warehousing. It is a very, very good business, especially in our new area we are developing. We are developing a new free zones area in Sekendi. And in the Sekendi export processing zone, we are going to see warehousing as a specialized arrangement. So we have told most of the developers coming into that area and most of the free zones enterprises coming to that area not to build warehouses. Because building warehouses may also worry your business. It may affect business somehow. So our interest as an authority is to encourage you to venture into warehouses that can also generate a lot of revenue for you and for the state. Now, the private sectors we talked about, manufacturing, textiles and garments, you can look at light industry, fabrication of hand tools and machinery. You can look at jewel manufacturing, processing of fruits and vegetables, and etc. In the service industry, I talk about business processing, outsourcing, data entry and processing, call centers, software development in the area of commercial and warehousing. I talk about repackaging of semi-finished goods, rebulking of industrial goods, and many more. In the area of infrastructure development or enclave development, we talk about build, operate, mostly that's what we are looking at now, especially in the Shama and the Sekendi enclave. We want people who will come in that arrangement, build, operate, and transfer. You come in, you partner with the Free Zones Authority, and that arrangement can be sealed, and we'll do business together. We are now trying also to look at, for the first time in the history of the Ghana Free Zones Arrangement, we are looking at the oil and gas free zones. It is a specialized arrangement that doesn't mostly function in areas like Ghana. You can only see that in the oil-rich countries that are doing extremely well. Talking about Saudi Arabia and the Gulf areas. But now, in Ghana, we are trying to start the oil and gas free zones. Specifically, we are going to look at the bunkering services. There are a lot of opportunities available. Many people would like to venture into these arrangements, and there are a lot of opportunities that are available that can help both of us. I'm talking about the private sector and the Free Zones Authority. Now, Free Zones Enterprise with British shareholding. Free Zones Enterprise with British shareholding. Now, so far, capital investment for companies that are operating in Ghana, Free Zones Capital are operating in Ghana with British shareholding, amounts to 194,503,809.40 US dollars. And we have been able to generate employment up to the tune of 9,058 for both Ghanaians and other expatriates. Those few companies with British shareholding have input data of 7,776,072,345.83 in terms of imports. And they've been able to export 1,231,407,607.09 US dollars. Some of the Free Zones companies with British shareholding include Blue Skies Ghana Limited. They process fresh fruit. Chedwell Limited, they into fragrance. Vecpro Ghana Limited, commercial farming of horticulture crops. Mem Cashew, they do cashew nut processing. Golden Exotics, they into fresh fruits. Ghana Specialty Fats Industries, they into shea butter processing. Canada Optical Laboratories, they into manufacturing of optical lenses, and so many companies, but we're not able to list all of them. Now, export processing zones that we have, our flagship EPZ is at Tema. Those who know Ghana very well, our flagship export processing zone is on the pond land, but in Tema, and that covers an area of 1,200 acres of land, and it houses almost about 99 factories. Some of the world brand or big multinational companies are situated there. Cargill is there. Barry Callebaut, the world's leader in chocolate manufacturing, they manufacture chocolate from the beginning stage to the last but one stage in Ghana, and export 100% to Switzerland. There are other companies that also operate in the Free Zones enclave that are doing so well in the international business value chain. We have also started a new development, the one that I'm talking about, the second D export processing zone. It is situated on three main communities at the Mpintin, Ano, and Ishim lands. And it's about 2,600 acres of land, almost about that. Recently they've added some to it. And so far, two major companies have situated on that land. Wankan Ceramic Company Limited and Dangote Cement. Other companies are also coming up, and we want to encourage a lot of investors here present to come and invest in Ghana through the Free Zones arrangement, because there are a lot of good things available for you. You may not know until you come to see for yourself what is happening in the sector, because now that area is developing into something else. We are about entering an agreement with a partner who is coming in as a Free Zones developer to develop that place into one of the best modern enclaves in the world. And there are a lot of space available for you to come in and invest. We have also the Ashanti Technologic Park, which is very close to a place called Bwankra. It is part of the Bwankra Industrial Hub. We have almost about 1,099 acres of land there. And that place is also phenomenal, a very nice situated area. And so far, we don't have any tenants there. We don't even have a developer who is ready to develop the place. So it's an opportunity for anybody who wants to venture into enclave development to come in and partner the Ghana Free Zones Authority to develop the area. We also have the Shama Land Bank at Yabeu. The Shama Land Bank is about 3,200 acres of land, and it is situated very close to the sea. We want to attract investments in the area of ecotourism and those who want to venture into oil, because that area is very close to Takoradi, and there are a lot of good facilities available to help anybody who venture or invest in that area. Now, procedures for establishment, or how can you become a free zones company? One, the first point is that before you be licensed as a free zones enterprise, you should be, the company must be incorporated in Ghana, or you must have a company that is incorporated in Ghana. So without that, the first point or the basic qualification is that you must have a company that is incorporated in Ghana. If you don't have a company that is incorporated in Ghana, you cannot be licensed as a free zones enterprise. So that's the first one. And also, in this case, you must have your certificate of incorporation, certificate to commence business, and the company regulations. You must also be able to prove to us that you have a business plan. You have a plan to run a business. So you have to show us evidence of your business plan for the business you want to set up, at either the feasibility study stage or any other thing. Then you have to also prove to us by showing us the environmental impact assessment certificate from the Environmental Protection Agency. Without this, you cannot get a license, because most people will come and they will just create unnecessary emission problems in the system. And this is what we're seriously fighting against. So most companies that were there before we came, we are trying to halt the operations because they are not, going strictly to whatever they sign with us in terms of trying to help us to create problems in the system. You have to also show evidence of transfer of funds. Most people want to set up free zones enterprises and they don't have money, but they only want to just show some one or two things. No, that's not what we're interested in. You have to prove to us that you have the money, you have the capacity, you have the strength or muscles to do business financially. So we want to see the evidence of it by transferring the money into the accounts, the business that you, I'm talking about the particular business that you have, you have to show us the money in the business. Then also, you have to also prove to us, either through memorandum of understanding or letter of intent, arrangement you have with a foreign entity that will be an off-taker, because we are in Ghana Provisions is operating the 70-30 principle, which means that whatever is produced, 70% must be exported. So there should be an off-taker to buy whatever you are selling. So without that, we cannot give you the license. People will come and they will say that they can only export 50%. You will not qualify. As it stands now, it's a 70-30 principle. And you should show us letter of intent from an off-taker or from a market in the foreign land. That is very, very important, because this is a purely offshore or export-oriented arrangement. And therefore, we are so strict when it comes to the 70-30 principle of free zones. You have to also show us evidence of lease or rental of land. People will want to do business, but their car boot is their offices. You cannot do free zones business or business in Ghana when you want to fall within the concept of free zones, because we want to see a location where you want to do your business. And that location must either be a bare land registered in your name or in the name of the business, or rented premises in the name of the company that want to be licensed as a free zones enterprise. So without that, you don't get the license to operate. Existing companies wishing to convert to free zones status should submit the following. So if you are operating as an existing company and you want to now shift to become a free zones company because you think you are doing more export and so you want to come to the concept, you must, one, submit to us the company's audited account for the last 3 years. So within the last 3 years, you should be able to prove to us that you have done business in a particular area and you were able to achieve this fate within a period, and your books look good. Because we don't want a situation where your books doesn't look good, and because you want to take advantage of the government and the system, you just want to run away from taxes and decide to come to the free zones. We will not allow that. You have to also show us senator clearance certificate that you've been paying your contribution. SNET is Social Security and National Insurance Trust. It's a pension situation for arrangement for government, where people who are employed in the formal sector, in some of the informal sector, some monies are saved there for them. And most employers take these monies and they don't pay to SNET. And that, it became a problem one day for the employees when they retire from active service. You have to also show us your tax clearance certificate from Ghana Revenue Authority through the Ministry of Finance. You have to also show us evidence to add value or increase employment. Because free zones is not just a normal arrangement. So you cannot just come and decide to employ five people and the five people will be for, no, that's not what we're looking for. You should be able to give us a plan or a program, how you're going to employ and the number of employment available for Ghanaians, especially the local people. There is no strict local content arrangement in terms of employment, but at least we should be able to see evidence or a program where you have a plan to help Ghanaians to also get employment and to also to develop their capacity within a period of time, which is very, very important. Some of the free zones enterprises that you would like to know, some companies doing so well. So the Ghana Free Zones Authority here, as I stand this afternoon, is only interested in one thing. What we are interested in is trying to attract investment in export-oriented area, especially in the area of manufacturing and enclave development. We need people who will come to partner with us to develop free zones enclaves in the form of export processing zones, special economic zones, technology parks, and other parks that will encourage export. Because we know that in other jurisdictions, free zones have done so well for countries. And we are so sure that with the help of the potential investors and investors here seated, you will help the Ghana Free Zones Authority to meet its goal or achieve its goal. Thank you and God bless us all.